What's up, y'all? It's Wednesday, October 23rd, 9:49 a.m. And today I'm gonna attempt to do a 5K at a 7-minute pace. It's gonna be a pace of 7:03 and 6:58 per mile, because my treadmill 8.5 is the 7:03. And then at 8.6 is a 6:58. There's no in between there. So, I've already done the 1 mile warm up. That's what I'm doing today, just the 1 mile warm up, and a few strides. So, as soon as I get up there, I'm gonna immediately start the treadmill on the 8.5, which is 7:03 per mile pace. And I'm gonna remain there for a little bit, maybe for about 800 meters, and then I'll speed up the pace to 6:58, and I'll toggle back and forth between those two paces. I mean, you know, if it feels fine at 6:58, I'm gonna continue all the way. But that's what I'm gonna do between those paces. So my goal is to do, to complete this 5K, which is 3 miles and 200 meters in 21 minutes. That's what it's gonna be. A 7-minute pace is a 21:44. 6:58 is a 21:38, I think, something like that. So anyway, it's gonna be in the 21s. So that's my goal. I'm gonna get this started. My legs are ready, I'm excited. So we'll see what happens. I'll say go on the watch and you'll know. And plus, I'm like just 10 seconds into the lap, just 10 seconds, so I'm not gonna really count that. So this will tell me exactly when I'm done, when I got the three miles at least, and then the 200 meters, I'll just guide it by the lap around the track. You can't see it, but it's like a blue line that goes around, so it's gonna be half of a 400 meter. So, all right, let's get this going. So we're gonna do 8.5 to 8.6. So that's a number 8 right there. And let's dial that into 8.5. That's 8.5 right there. All right, let's go.
fun. 658. Turn the fan on. Left. 3 miles. 200 meters left. Let's speed it up. Finished those last 200 meters, going down to 640, 653, 645, 640. Ha! Okay, guys. So I completed a 5K in 21 minutes and 40 something seconds, maybe 50. Still 21 minutes, under 22 minutes and 39 seconds. So I did this a minute faster than my best 5K so far. I did 22:38 on my last one. And right here you saw it, 21 and change. And that was it, man. I feel good. I ended last week with 40 miles. This week, I'm going a little lower. If I would have gone any higher starting this week, I wouldn't probably been able to do this as good today. I did 7 miles on Monday. I took off yesterday. So between this run and the last 2 mile at 7 minute pace after right after the 3 miles. Was 3 days ago, so I rested 2 days in between. 2 days is good for me. Some of you may need a little longer, maybe three, but that's how you go about it. You know, make sure you rest at least 2 days minimum, two, three days, which is even better if you can. You know, if you can hold yourself back. Anyway, more faster times, of course. You know, the 7 minute pace. It's becoming easy for me, you know, and that's the idea. You know, you want to make your pace comfortable for you. You know, there's no way that you could finish something like this in training with your tongue out, you know, with your tongue hanging out to the floor. You know, you can't be that exhausted. Otherwise, you're working way above your 100% capacity. In order for you to be able to run at a fast pace like this at a 7 minute or faster, your fitness has to improve, you know. You have to increase your fitness, aerobic fitness. It helps tremendously. It helps lower your heart rate, okay, your resting heart rate. So by your heart rate being lower at rest, it allows you to push more and increase, you know, your heart rate, but not so much because you're a lot fitter. So that's the way it works, man. Yeah, man, so I'm excited. 21 minutes and change, and I'll be back again soon. Thank you for watching.